rounds in the Kate McKinnon.
Testing the microphone. I think we're... Here we go. So with these dynamic microphones, I've learned that you got to let them warm up for a couple seconds. So I think we're warm. We're here. It's fucking June something. It's late June. Haven't recorded an episode since late May. Last one we dropped was Charleston. That was a little while ago now. And yeah, we're here, man. We're still in the saddle kicking it hard, rocking my polo sweats, drinking my fucking San Pellegrino like a real fucking wop. And just got done watching the fucking new season of Black Mirror, dude. And I know I'm late on this. It released a few months ago. But, yeah, not impressed. Not that impressed with Black Mirror as of late. And so, yeah, I just turned up the gain a little bit. Hopefully that helps for sound quality. But, yeah, man, Black Mirror, if you don't know Black Mirror is a show, and I watched the earlier seasons around, like, 2017, maybe. Fucking time flies. I don't even know what year it is anymore. All I know is we need a war with Russia. But the early days of Black Mirror were fucking good. Black Mirror is, I've heard, be compared to a modern version of The Twilight Zone. For any of you old heads out there, which I never saw The Twilight Zone, I was busy getting introduced to South Park at like 6 years old, Beavis and Butthead. Pretty cool Beavis and Butthead story. My dad used to cut the hair of Mike Judge, the creator. And his hair salon was featured in an episode called Top of the Mountain. Yeah, but anyways, with Black Mirror, the older episodes were crazy. Like, they would literally mind fuck you. I'd go to bed feeling different. And now they're just not as good. Like, there was one episode that was pretty good. But they're just, like, gay now. They're woke. And they have, like, every fucking episode has... interracial couple, and it's just it's what happens when you let women in the writer's room. TBH, sorry, not sorry, but yeah, it's true. And yeah, they're just I feel like they are being like good, you know, people now. They're like being obedient to what you can put on Netflix today. Netflix sucks now, dude. Like, the last good show on Netflix, and by good, I don't mean Outer Banks. That's like, that's the difference. There's a difference between a good show and a show that you can just binge. Okay? A good show is like Breaking Bad. Or like, what's the fucking, The Wire. Or Narcos. Those are good shows. The last good show released on Netflix was probably Ozark.
even though I never finished it. I thought it was pretty good. But, like, yeah, dude, again, with the Outer Banks and shit, it's like you're just putting on the screen good-looking people that you want to fuck so you can sit there on the couch with your hand in your pants, which is what I'm doing right now, and just watching things and people and like, oh, I'd fuck them, so I'm going to watch this show. It's kind of what TV is now. You got to have one black person. You got to have them standing right next to a white person. You got to have the LGBT QRXTUV in there. You got to have one of them. You got to have one of they thems in there. God forbid you have a chiseled jaw, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant. It just wouldn't fly. It just won't fly. So, yeah, dude. I was sitting here on the couch, you know, it's Sunday, and I was going, man, feeling kind of wanting to do something creative, is a lack of better word. This isn't creative. This is just fucking puking out of the mouth. But I just wanted to do something. I didn't want to move, like, my body. Like, I didn't want to, like, play guitar, like, exercise. I just wanted to, like, do something other than sit here. And I got a full belly. So I just said, ah, fuck it. Let's plug it in, dude. Let's go live and just get after it on the fucking pod. Shout out Jake. Only regular listener I probably have now, which I'm fine with. I started this podcast about a year ago for just fun and mindless dilly-dallying amongst this fucking crazy world we live in, which we're going to get into, of course. You know, we're gonna get into it. We're going to get right into that because, like, yeah, man. It's 2023. And there's a lot going on. There is uneasiness in Eastern Europe. Putin is probably going to get thrown out or whatever is going on with that. Sorry, I don't have all the facts. I just know that Let's fucking pull it up, Jamie, real quick. Because I do want to get some things right here. So some guy who's in charge of, like, the military in fucking Russia. Not Putin. Some other dude. A Jewish guy, by the way. It is just a detail. Don't get offended. Moscow, blah, 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 resistant Wagner group, Ukraine, Putin, Vladimir Zelensky. I didn't even think about that. Vladimir and Vladimir Zelensky, they have the same first name. Pretty much. So I guess Wagner, I'm sorry, guys. And by guys, I mean probably Jake, and that's it. But yeah, I don't know, dude. Honestly, Russia. God damn it! Why can't I fucking find? Okay, Wagner mercenary group who led an uprising against the Russian military leadership began to end hostilities and head to Belarus. New York Times article. So basically, here's the latest on the situation in Russia. A sense of uncertainty and confusion pervaded Russia on Sunday after the strongest challenge to President Vladimir Putin's rule appeared to have been diffused. And this guy, whose name I cannot pronounce, it's Yevgeny Prigozhin. Yeah, I don't know how to say that at all. The head of the mercenary force known as the Wagner Group, who led an armed uprising against the military's leadership for 24 hours this weekend, punctured Putin's blistering criticism, actions called into question justifications of Russia's entering the war in Ukraine, and
competency, I cannot fucking read today, of its military leadership. So I think that they're trying to, like, get Putin out, but honestly, who cares? That's the thing at the same time, dude. Who fucking cares? You know, they're not coming here. They're not going to fuck with I. Come over here. See what some Teams bros would do to you if you fucking came into the homeland. See what some Teams bros and some Green Berets would do if you dared knocked on our front door politely. If you even considered the idea of ringing our doorbell in a polite manner, you would be on your fucking ass faster than you can say Oklahoma. All right? You come over here with your fucking communism, dictatorship bullshit. I'm talking to you, anybody. China, Russia, Korea, whoever the fuck. Come on down to fucking Norfolk, where they got some Teams bros, or on the other coast, where they got fucking Pendleton and whatever base is down there in Dago Way, San Diego Way. See what the Teams bros would do. Come up from the south. Yeah, you fucking wish, dude. You fucking wish. My boys at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. No, not going to end well for you guys. So, that's really all I care about, dude, is I love my country. I love my guns. No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, so I don't know. I just don't really care anymore about Ukraine and Russia and whatever's going on over there. And, you know, the fucking, what else is in the news? Talking about the submarine. Like, again, who gives a fuck? You know, you got billionaires, rich billionaires, who wanted to go look at the Titanic for $250,000 a ticket. They deserve to die. I'm sorry. Do you know how fucking deep the Titanic was? I think it was 12,000 feet. Jamie, pull that up. Here we go. We're going to do it like this. How deep is the Titanic? The Titanic wreckage was about 12,500 feet deep in the North Atlantic Ocean. Told you. That's as deep as about 9 Empire State Buildings stacked. Holy shit. That's fucking deep. Bro, that's deeper. That's deeper than I get in that pussy. Bro, that's deeper. That's deeper than I get with my therapist. You know what I mean? That's deeper than I dive in the pussy on a Sunday. Yeah. Who gives a fuck about the Titanic? About Ukraine, right? I mean, fuck. Here's the thing, right? This is the thing, and I want you to listen very closely. We're not doing well. We're not doing well as a nation. Okay? Tough guy. Gas is almost $4. Eggs are fucking the same price. For 12 eggs, not like good locally farm-raised chicken eggs. No, I'm talking about store brand name, like Great Value. Fucking Harris Teeter brand eggs. Looking at like $2.79 for a dozen. You realize you should be able to cop those for 79 cents? See, I don't know how far your memory goes, but I remember when gas was $1.89. Things were easier. And I'm not just talking economically. We're going to get into it. Ever since this bullshit
started in 2020. You got fucking literal whores, actual whores, fingering their fucking cooch on OnlyFans and making money off it. All right. You got fucking kids being told that they can chop off their dick in math class. Right? You got fucking men lonelier than ever. Why is that? Well, there has been an attack. There has been an attack on straight white men. Yes or yes? I don't care who you are. I don't care if you don't believe that. If you think it's part of whatever bullshit. But it's the facts are the facts, okay? I've heard it said in person, in real life, more than once, the term straight white male with a someone on the offensive against the us against us. Yeah, there's an attack. There's definitely an attack against straight white males. We're seen as Nazis. We're seen as rapists and whatever, what have you. So best way to combat it is to ignore it. Get off the phone, get off the social media, which I have been doing. I guess that's another reason I'm recording a podcast, to kind of do something else other than sit on fucking Discord all goddamn day. Excuse my language. It's Sunday. I shouldn't say that, honestly. But yeah, so that's a thing. And this hypergamy now, this word I learned, sounds smart. Thank you very much, Jordan Peterson. Where, you know, the hypergamy means basically the hierarchy of choice. The action of, here's the actual definition. The action of marrying or forming a sexual relationship with a person of superior sociological or educational background. Hypergamy. Marrying up. In other words, for my retards out there. So you have apps like Tinder and Bumble and Hinge, right? And within these apps, you have a cesspool of whores. Sorry, I'm just going to call a spade a spade. They're fucking coochie and their tits and their feet and their ass are just showing off, just out. All right, and I just, yes, of course, obviously it's attractive. The more skin is more attractive than not. But with that being said, fuck that. I'm to the point now where I want me just a nice traditional woman. Give me a fucking long blue sundress, right, with sandals, pretty pink toenails, you know, with luscious, long, thick brown hair, messy bun, whatever, with long green eyes. That's all I need, boy. She likes to cook. Maybe we raise a couple chickens. You know, my woman and the kids and the dogs and me, Hank Williams Jr., baby. And so with but straight up with this marrying up hypergamy thing going on, it's like, you give millions of people access to a phone and these dating apps like Tinder, where they can go and swipe right or swipe left. What does that do for people? No, I'm asking. No, I'll tell you what it does for people, in my experience at least. It makes them more picky, okay? Selective. It makes it I'm not very sharp as far as my words today go. Hey, it's fucking Sunday. I got no shirt on. I'm sitting here on the couch in polo sweats drinking San Pellegrino. Fuck with me, Poppy. So, yeah, you get these people, right? And then they get the freedom of choice to swipe right or swipe left, okay? What does that do? It makes them more picky. It makes them selective to who they can pick on, who they can pick, right? So if I'm fucking Stephanie from fucking Greenville and I'm 24 and I just graduated from the University of Casual Sex and Beer, whatever, and I want a fucking man, I'm going to swipe. And I'm going to make my profile. My tits are out. Maybe my tongue is out. Right, I'm looking just skanky, just demonic in this day and age. Christ would be fucking rolling over if he saw what the girls are dressing like, man. It's honestly fucking annoying. But I definitely have been tempted by the devil when I look, you know. Obviously, that's a thing. But you know, they can look as hot as they want. They can put the filter on, right? Fucking. You know, the 3D fucking filter with the makeup, put some fucking eye shit in their fucking face, just look like a fucking whore. Hot as hell. Sexy as fuck, right? Doing squats in the gym on a boat with some fucking millionaire. They just sucked his cock. And then they're on Tinder, looking like Skankfest. And then they can just swipe on whoever. Because they know damn well with their tits out, they're going to get swiped on. So it's slim pickings for them because, you know, they get to pick whoever they want. And if you're not, and I heard this on Instagram, or not Instagram, whatever the fuck, Discord probably is the only app I use. If you're not 6 foot, if you don't make six figures, if your dick isn't at least 6 inches, then keep it moving. Then keep it moving. So they can be as picky as they want. You know, you're literally swiping on rich trust fund, white Anglo-Saxon Protestant models, WASP models, 6'3". Chiseled fucking jaw. Daddy bought him a fucking Range Rover. Got the white Range. Call that shit Larry Bird. You know what I'm saying? And they're just on it. These dudes are just plowing. These dudes are just fucking plowing, dude. They're getting... Most of the girls are swiping on a small amount of guys. That's just what it is out there. Young kings. All right, kings, if you're listening to this, that's just the name of the game. You know, you got to be tall, athletic, rich. You know, you got to be self-made. You got to be confident. You got to be funny. Or fuck you. Go kill yourself. If you are not perfect, if you are not 100% in touch with everything, top shelf, fucking Patron, like, if you're not living that baller lifestyle, go fuck yourself, you Nazi. You straight white male piece of shit. You know, and then if you're a chick, it's like, they got no morals these days, dude. Go on these apps. It's fucking absurd. The bio will say, you know, looking for a quick fuck. Or friends with benefits. Or, you know, tongue emoji and just bullshit. So as far as romance, dating, 2023, all I gotta say is good luck out there, young kings. Men are more lonely than they have ever been today. Suicide, drug overdose, depression, alcoholism,
It's at an all-time high. The numbers are there. Their numbers are at an all-time high, just like the gas prices. Everything's fucking high right now. And there's nothing you can do about it, so you might as well slap a Ukraine sticker on your bumper, you piece of shit. Support the regime. Join the fight. You know, fuck that. Fuck that. Jesus stood alone, man. He was killed by his own people. He was brought to the Romans court by his own people. Tried and fucking put on the cross. That man stood alone. He stood alone just like another man who I'm thinking of who I hope we get to see again. Because this ain't working. This ain't the fucking America that I was born into. I don't know about y'all. I don't know about y'all, man. Shit, motherfucker. Hey, but there's a big but. I like big butts, and I cannot lie. But at least I got my soda water. At least I got the pool, you know? At least I got entertainment, podcast, music, the gym. And hey, at least I got a few honey birds that'll be swiping on me on Tinder, maybe, if I'm so fortunate. You know? No, but it is funny. There was a study that said that, man. The most girls swipe on a very small amount of men. So you have a few men fucking most girls. And then you have the rest of us, 80% or whatever, are just sitting here recording podcasts. You know, oh, fuck, dude. There was a really good meme I saw that explains everything. And I'm going to paraphrase it. But it was a girl's tweet that said, why do men start podcasts instead of going to therapy? Bitch. The male responded and said, the same reason women start OnlyFans instead of getting a job. Fucking burn. That's a good one. By the way, I do both, so I'm better than you. But yeah, I thought that was fucking great. You know, trying to take some time away from the phone, but memes cure. Memes cure. Memes cure everything. Almost. So, yeah, man. It is summer. It is a fucking white boy summer. Don't let anybody tell you different. I want to go on a trip. I want to go somewhere tropical and warm, maybe Florida, maybe Costa Rica, or a fuck around and find out, go to Italy. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. I just haven't decided yet what I want to do. Very grateful, very fortunate for the life I get to lead today. Got some savings, got great health. I'm working on not just faith, but spiritual principles, being honest with myself and others, being open-minded to try new things, being willing, having trust in the process, faith that it will work out. And yeah, man, just hope. You know, as dark as things are and may get in our society today with just the division and the economy and the cost of goods and just bullshit, just social media and I do really feel like there's just a dark cloud looming over everything. Maybe I need to get off my phone and just get into the world more. But you know, with all that darkness, there is no light without darkness. There's no light without darkness, man. It's just that's just you know, you can't have one thing without the other. It's the yin and the yang. Yeah, it's you know, it's the yin and the yang here. Maybe there's a quote or two I can. Yeah, hope is being able to see that there is light despite all of the darkness. It's fucking deep, bro. That's real deep. That's good. That's fucking fire. I had a really good weekend. I hung out with my friend Kenny. We played some pool. And summer nights are great. I do have fun with all that, going out, walking around, talking to people, being silly, fireworks, concerts. Summer is here. Summer is in full swing. And, you know, so just hanging out with some teams, bros. Damn, that Bible quote is absolute fire. Got a text from my homie. Don't want to dox him. But the quote goes like this, and this is from Isaiah 41:10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Amen. Good night, everyone.